non-Muslim students, perhaps, let's just not bring up our differences. Let's just say that we are all friends. We love each other and we'll hug each other. I had a tough time with that. Because how can we do that and at the same time, truly, Shias and Sunnis are killing each other today? They really are killing each other. True, the last time that Shias and Sunnis killed each other was in the 18th century. And the last time specifically it happened in Iraq, from within the Iraq, an intra-Iraqi conflict, was in the year 1049, Christian era. Long time ago. But the tension has always been there. And the status quo was kept in place because we were able to keep our books away from each other, our communities away from each other, our teachings away from each other, and we condemned each other. You know, guess what? We don't have that choice anymore. We have the internet now. We have satellite TVs now. We have others who have a lot of interest in seeing us kill each other. And we're willing participants in that conspiracy. So what do we do now? I propose to you a number of things. One, with the Shia brothers and sisters, you need to know what makes our Sunni brothers and sisters understand us. If you love Ali, understand why you love Ali, and explain why you love Ali. Because if you dance around the subject, people can smell it, they can sniff it. If you love Ahlul Bayt, learn how to answer the question. Isn't it strange that we have our 12th Imam in occultation and he has been gone for 1,000 years? If you don't know how to answer that question, then you have a problem. Learn your own faith and learn to respect the thinking and the faith of your Sunni brothers and sisters. For the Sunni brothers, I want to say the same thing. I don't know, brothers and sisters, how many times we have to tell you we don't have another Quran. I became Shia 27 years ago. I went to Iran. I toured Iran, north to south, east to west. I went to the Shia masjids. And if my Shia brothers and sisters are still hiding that Shia Quran from me, I'm going to sue them over that. Because I haven't seen it. What disgusts me vehemently is when people say, you know, are there Sunni masjids in Iran? Are there Shia masjids in Jordan? Since when do we have different masjids? We have the same Qibla, we have the same La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. We have the same Salah, we have the same Wudu, we have the same Quran. Please, brothers and sisters, don't tell me at any point that we say that Ali is better than Muhammad. What every Shia would be quick to tell you, and Allah is my witness, is that what we believe is that Ali, as he said himself, he was asked, Ali, where are you compared to the Prophet? He said, وَيْحَكُمْ وَهَلْ عَلِيٌّ إِلَّا عَبْدٌ مِّنْ عَبِيدِ مُحَمَّدٍ. Is Ali but a slave of Muhammad? No. What do we have to do to prove to you that when we say the takbirat at the end of salah, we really are saying Allahu Akbar? Brothers and sisters, it's in Sahih Muslim. That's how the Prophet used to pray. How many times do we have to say that the subject of mut'a, and I'm touching on the subjects that over the last 27 years, I have been faced with day in and day out, because I will tell you, over the last 27 years, I have debated with Christians, Jews, and Sunnis. And I'm very sorry to put Sunnis with Christians and Jews, but it's a practical fact. But these are the questions that I face. The problem they see with our my Shia brothers and sisters is that when they discuss this matter with Sunni brothers and sisters, is they really have no idea where to start. We have different planes to think, to start at. the subject of khilafah, we think differently about Shias. I'm not saying that the other side is bad. Please bear with me as I explain to you what Shias believe about khilafah. It is important. Inshallah, I will give you three examples of intellectual differences that we have that we should embrace, not fight over. Look, brothers and sisters, we have the same Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Baqarah, and bear with me, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ Allah said to Adam, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةٌ The word khalifa comes twice in the Quran. إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةٌ And the other surah, is the other ayah is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to Dawood, يَا دَاوُد إِنَّا جَعَلْنَاكَ خَلِيفَةً فِي الْأَرْضِ Did you notice that both words khalifa were preceded by one word with ja'l? Now those of you who know Arabic and know the Quran will know that the word ja'l, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does ja'l for something, nobody else gets involved. Not the malaika, not the messengers, prophets, nobody else. It's an ordinance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a decree. Inni ja'al fil ardi khalifa. He didn't say, should I? Put a khalifa on earth. Both. Now, khalifa and imam, anybody who knows Arabic will understand that the imam is the functional job of the khalifa. Lingually, I'm talking about, not theologically now. Okay? So the imam or the khalifa performs his duties actually in practicality because a khalifa doesn't necessarily sometimes perform his duties for whatever reason. When the Khalifa performs his duties, practically he becomes, he's called an Imam. Now, the word Imam was mentioned 5 times in the Quran. I'll mention one of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Ibrahim, Allah tells Ibrahim, إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا Did you notice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word جَاعِل? Ibrahim didn't say, Ya Allah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Ibrahim that he's going to have a child at an old age, he said, Ya Allah, I'm an old man. But when he said, إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا, Ibrahim did not debate. He submitted. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was Muslim. Hanif and Muslim. So both, in the cases of Khilafah and Imam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did the ja'al. It's a decree from him. Now Shias believe that a Khalifa has to exist at all times, otherwise the purpose of creation goes away. And that if a Khalifa goes away, that the earth will go away. And I can almost hear my brothers and sisters, some of the Sunni brothers and sisters here saying, see, I told you the Shias are just exaggerating everything. But please bear with me. Look, let's look at the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the first ayah, when he tells the malaika, he says, إِنِّي جَاعِلُ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً The malaika inquired from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ We need to look at every word. And sister, if I go over my time, I'll take from Brother Hassani's time. Thank you, brother. Excuse me. Okay? Now, let's just together contemplate the Quran because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ By the way, how many of you brothers and sisters know Arabic? Okay, we Arabs have a problem. We have to have more Arabs show up from now on, right? Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةٌ With that, the malaika inquire from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, would you create a khalifa on earth while we glorify you and praise you? And that khalifa would shed blood. I want to focus on this word, blood. Not shed, not ifsad. Just look at the word blood. Blood is defined as a thing. It's an object. It's an object that we all know. It's an us, it's in animals, it's in everything, right? No question about that. So Malaika knew what blood was. This was before Adam was created. The second thing is the Malaika say, you create a Khalifa, we worship you, we glorify your name and praise you. نُسَبِّحُ وَنَحْمَدُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. Okay? So the two things.